Sure. I'll tell you the story. I can see the setting now. A raining night for the mercenary. It was just another day in his village. After carrying a rucksack of food. The once former man with a look of unkempt. His beard and hair has overgrown. And what was once eyes filled with pride and adventure is now empty and dark. From the restless nights he laid thinking about that day, thinking about that girl he ruined. It's been years. She's either a teenager or worse, dead. But he continues to move unconsciously, as he always did, hoping that this day would be his last. He hears footsteps sprinting with determination and anger. A past that is awakened to confront him. A girl, breathless, but eager to let out years of pain to what is now known as the girl who was left behind. It's you.
Why did you do it?
How are you still?
Answer my question.
Yes. I took your parents from you because of my lust for greed. That's all I ever cared about. Until I saw that girl that I left behind. Scared. Alone. Holding her father and mother. Confused why they couldn't hold you back. I've never forgot what I did that day. I spent nights wondering what happened to that girl.
You took my life away, my childhood. All because you were greedy. You're stupid, stupid greed.
No. Even when I had gotten paid for that horrible act, the money had rested in my living room table for years. I had never mustered the strength to use what I had used that day. Because I had given my humanity away for greed. I gave up who I was, and since that day I begged God to end me. For the girl I hurt. You didn't deserve that. You didn't deserve any of that. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Maybe you can't fix what you've done. And I don't think I can ever forget what you have done to me and my family. But maybe there is a way for peace.
But I had taken everything from you. You were just a small child, and I ripped you from your family. Take everything. My money. My life. I don't deserve to live. Just make it quick.
You're miserable enough. And doing any of that won't fix what you've done either. I miss my family. I miss my parents. But this is not what they would want.
How? Nothing I can do will ever make up for what I have done to you. For what I have done to them.
You can. You can't adopt me. I won't have anyone else. It's better than not having anyone at all.
You would want me to watch after you? Of course. Anything you need. To give you a chance at life, it's the least I can do. You have my word. I'll do whatever it takes. Oh, and my name is Hirokatsumi. And I would be honored to take care of you.
Hana. Hana Mayumi is my name.
Well, Hana, you must be starving, and luckily for you, I was just about to bring home food for the night. Would you care to join me?
Yes, it would be great to have a nice meal.
All right, Hannah. Let's go home. And as they sit, walking home, to a new life, one finding peace, while the other one finding redemption to what was the loss of such a tortured and tormented life, they both found a new family, a new hope. And one day, maybe even these wounds will heal, and forgiveness can spread a new life.